Hello everyone, today I'm going to be sharing with you my 2022 planner setup. I have a very basic and simple system that really helped me to be more productive and focus on my to-do list. So I keep in my planner two inserts, one time-based planner and one task-based planner. For the task-based planner, I use the Traveler's Notebook Free Diary, which means it's not dated, weekly plus memo. And it basically looks like this. So on the left, you have a blank horizontal layout for the week, not dated, and another next to it grid, they call it the memo. Now, when I first got this, I was thinking I will keep up with the weekly spreads, but that didn't work with my schedule because most of my weekly tasks, work assignments and meetings are handled by the Outlook. So I decided to convert this to a task to-do list or projects that I need to work on. It can be before a trip. It can be, as you can see here, shopping list, to-do list, very focused on the tasks that I need to do. I created here a spread for ideas that I need to journal about, and that really worked much better for me, because when you realize you cannot keep up with your planner, that means you're working for the planner and not the other way around, and obviously that defeats the purpose. So we moved to a new house and I had projects related to our new home and so on. So now that is not time based, I still have few pages to go with. So this is not gonna change. It's gonna travel with me to 2022 as is, and I'm only gonna change it when I run out of pages. Now, for that purpose, you don't necessarily need to have that particular planner. I already had it, that's why I used it, and I also like the green color and the contrast it creates with the stickers. So, but really and truly, you can use a dotted or grid one because it's like an organized to-do list, and that's what I call a task-based planner. Now, for the time-based planner, I used from Traveler's Notebook the monthly, and that is where I log all the appointments and everything time-based. Over here, they have a blank, well, like the 12-month with a table and the number of days in the month labeled as travel plan, and that kind of inspired me to log all my traveling of the year and color-coded based if it's international or within the United States or cities that we visited within the state of Texas where we live. Consistently, more or less, I decorated my spreads with art washi tapes. I had fun doing that. But this is where I log appointments, delivery dates, events to attend, anything that I need in terms of time, travel dates, everything. That was much more practical for me. Of course, after this, they give you some pages for references, you know, if you travel with it, maps and units. And then they leave you with few blank pages. For that, I just decided to have fun with stickers that reminded me with the main events we attended during the year, like the opera, some of the museum exhibitions. And I look at it and I remember the highlights. I really like Downton Abbey tea and so on. It can be some of the, I also added some of the sketching I was. So now if I go back and look at it, I not only remember my schedule during that year, but I also see some of the main highlights of that year. So it's nice to look at it. However, because this is the time-based one, that is going to go and be replaced with this one over here, my new monthly time-based planner for 2022. I already decorated the cover. I have this right after my plastic folder, which I call family album. I keep it here. I only decorated the cover page. And I added all the labels, so that's gonna saves me time, with the month, the name of each month. And for the craft envelope where I keep my writing board, this is where it hosts my task planner or my to-do list. And over here I have the folder with some stamps to kind of decorate my spreads. That's it. It's very basic. My time planner, my task planner. You can also add some of your the tags. If it's one of those spreads that you feel you go back to it more and like frequently, and you want to have an easy access to it, that's also was a practical tip. That's it, and then I keep it all together, easy, functional, and I guess my only comment or take out of this is that the planner should work for you and should fulfill the purpose of helping you to be more organized and focused on your to-do list, not to overwhelm you or distract you by following a particular system. Let me know if you have any questions or comments, and see you later.